Visit G2A.com for the lowest digital game prices on the market.
I'm hot. My sugar's low. Somebody drank all my Pepsis. I gotta drink Diet Pepsi. I got a can right here, actually. And I don't want to play Call of Duty and my feet hurt. That's about how I feel, to quote the great Wings of Redemption. That's about how I feel on any given day when I have to even just look at this game and look at this franchise and look at all the just cringy stuff they're doing on a day-to-day basis. But, you know, it's something I signed on to do. So I might as well make the best of it and have some fun with it, which is why I made this new Desert Dave Ram Power Wagon shirt available at my Merchland link in the video description, as well as the pinned top YouTube comment. I just kind of want to make some shirts making fun of this game, because that's about the only enjoyment I actually get. And this is a limited edition shirt, so get them while you can. I think it's only available for the next 2 weeks or so. But anyway, a lot of people in the community have just stopped posting Cold War, or they stopped playing Call of Duty altogether, or they just exclusively do Warzone. And, you know, I don't blame them. I really don't. Multiplayer on Call of Duty, like traditional 6v6 multiplayer, which is what I was born and raised on, like the good old days, it's still good. It's still good when you get a good game to back it up. But, you know, a lot of people have moved on, and I don't blame them. I think Thunder even went back to World War II. There's something about Cold War and Modern Warfare 2019 in particular. And I know what it is. I've covered it a million times in countless videos, but to really just sit down and play these games, you can't like grasp how unenjoyable the games actually are until you just sit down and play it. You might see something they're doing and thinking it's a good idea. You might see some content they're dropping and you might be thinking, wow, that looks great. I'd like to, you know, try that out in game. But until you actually play the games, the 6v6 multiplayer component, you don't know how awful it truly is. You just don't. I can't put it into words. Not even my signature catchphrase of the game being boring can really show how boring it actually is. And you know, it's so boring, in fact, that the devs are dropping like flies. And dare I say, it's worse than being boring. It's flat out just dog shit. But the devs are leaving the sinking ship of Treyarch and they're going elsewhere. One of the big news stories recently, which I haven't covered yet, is that Byron Bead left Treyarch just recently. I think it was just a month or two ago, and is now the new general manager for Battlefield. What does that tell you? Not only that, but last year we had Jason Blundell. I think he was one of the lead design directors for Zombies. He peaced out. These veterans, these guys who have been with the company for a long time, are leaving. And let's not forget back in the day, Robert Bowling leaving as well. And, you know, that should have been the signal. Like, that should have been the beginning of the end signal. When Robert Bowling, the stealth clown, the community punching bag himself, finally had enough. I think he left after Modern Warfare 3, and it's no real surprise, Infinity Ward games after Modern Warfare 3 have been absolute dog water. I don't think I have seen a studio perform worse on just missing the boat that is what makes Call of Duty fun. And I'm sorry if you like Ghosts, I'm sorry if you like Infinite Warfare, and I'm definitely sorry if you like Modern Warfare 2019, but, you know, stop it, get some help, to quote the great Michael Jordan. Not that Michael Jordan, that's the wrong, NyQuil Jordan, no, that's not right. Look, guys, people are leaving. The devs are leaving. The players are leaving. And this really just reminds me of current day professional wrestling, specifically WWE. I might alienate some viewers here by kind of talking about this and ranting about this, but I'm gonna make the comparison anyway. You know, when I was growing up, wrestling was like the coolest thing ever. Professional wrestling, you had WCW, you had WWF, you had Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock, Hulk Hogan, Sting, Lex Luger, Kevin Nash, Scott Hall. You know, everybody probably knows these guys, even though they they might not be a huge fan of wrestling, but like, who in the hell do you honestly know in real life that still watches wrestling? I'll catch AEW from time to time. I like AEW. It's great. But if we actually look at the big dog here, WWE, it's trash. I don't know how anyone sits through it and their numbers continue to dwindle. With that said, they keep making a lot of money. They're great businessmen. Just like the suits at Activision are great businessmen, they know how to market their product, and they know that the smart money is in the dumb money. Appeal to the lowest, form of intelligence out there, they're going to eat it up. Look at all the stuff that's gotten popular in the past, 5-10 years. Fidget spinners, vaping, Tide Pods, people doing weird shit to Drake songs running next to their car, ice bucket challenges. I mean, we as a generation, and I'm talking about millennials, I'm talking about is it Gen X, Gen Z? I don't know what to call you guys that are younger than millennials, but whatever the hell you are. we are in this era where we're basically bored. We're very bored. So we do things that aren't the smartest, and we act on emotion and we act on trends, Call of Duty has jumped on the Fortnite trend. Call of Duty used to be a trailblazer for original ideas, and people used to rip Call of Duty off. I don't know what happened. It's like after Black Ops 2, they lost all originality and their games just kept getting gradually worse after that. There were some shining moments. I really liked Black Ops 3, but I can't think of anything else after Black Ops 2 that I would call a classic Call of Duty. And I mean, even though I played a lot of Black Ops 4 and I like Black Ops 4, I think Black Ops 3 is way better. And if I'm being honest, Black Ops 4 was a game that I enjoyed because it was the last true Call of Duty. I really came to appreciate that game after Modern Warfare 2019 came out, because on Black Ops 4, I can move! I can move around the map! I don't feel like a 500-pound sumo wrestler with an elephant strapped to his back and oily shoes. That's how I feel playing Modern Warfare 2019. I put a grip on my gun, and suddenly I gain 40 pounds, and I move around like I just cleaned out the buffet at the Golden Corral. I can't stand that not moving, peekaboo bullshit, creep around a corner, stick your little winky through the door gameplay. I'm just not into it. And I think that I'm getting kind of sidetracked here, but the point is that WWE is a sinking ship. Less and less people are watching it weekly, right? Call of Duty's in the same boat. It really is. They're making tons of money because they know how to market stupid skins to stupid kids, but are the games good? No. Objectively, they're bad, and they release unfinished. Is the player base booming? We don't have the hard data. They won't release it, but I would say, no, I showed you guys some pretty damning evidence against people actually playing the game, and I think you can actually find Warzone players online somewhere. I can't imagine it's gaining players. It's about a year old now, right? A little bit over a year old now. I can't imagine it's actually booming with the lack of anti-cheat and the fact that, I'm sorry, I call Cold War boring. Warzone is just as boring. It really is. Sorry to say. And people will say oh man, it's fun with friends. Huh. You know what else is fun with friends? Getting high and watching old Jackie Chan movies on VHS. Making pancakes while you're drinking Bud Light. I mean, you can make anything fun if you're hanging out with your friends. I can make farting in church fun if I'm hanging out with them. That would be kind of fun. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make is that it's just this trend mentality. Battle Royale is popular. People jump on Battle Royale because the game's free. They nickel and dime you to death with microtransactions. Your friends play it, though, because they make bad financial decisions and are poor and spend all their money on skins and stuff. And the game's free, so they think they're getting a better deal or something like that. I don't know. The point is, your friends are dumb. Get new friends if they play Warzone and Battle Royale and shit. I'm just sick of this, I only play because my friends play it. If your friend jumped off a bridge and to their death, would you do the same? That's an old expression, but goddamn, it's true. I mean, it's if my friends watch WWE, Like, if they came over to my house and tried to turn on Raw, I would slap them. I would slap them across the face and be like, what are you doing, man? Be the voice of reason. Be the light of logic in your friend's life. Like, get them to stop playing stupid, unfun bullshit that frustrates them. Anyway, guys, I'm out of time. I hope you enjoyed. Rate, comment, and subscribe. Pick up your Ram Power Wagon Desert Dave Overlanding shirt at the Merchland link below. I want to suplex Joe Sakott through the DVRs that have Raw and SmackDown from WWE recorded. I'll see you guys later. Peace.